appreciated, and that was in the budget this time last year. Government, however, has spent money mainly on consultants. We're quite well paid consultants telling us what we already know. No help to us whatsoever. Just defending us to the cabinet colleagues and other authorities also in fire and police who all residents contribute to our council tax bills. We would like a response to the cross-party scrutiny report on the nuclear explosion and lessons to be learned from that cross-board. Thank you.
Thank you. Councillor Barrett, Chris, sorry.
It's all right. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. My initial is B, so I'll thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd just like to take a moment to talk a little to the inclusion in the proposed budget of forest schools, which was reported by Council Leader Hackett. As a teacher, forest schools are especially close to my heart, and I'm delighted that this budget will restore some funding for this hugely beneficial project. All children benefit from escaping from time to time from the confines of the conventional classroom, but this is all the more important for children from underprivileged backgrounds who may have also very limited access to a healthy outdoor environment. This is why the Birkenhead and Brenton Green Councillors have been happy to use our ward fund to provide extra places this year for children from Home Start to attend classes in Birkenhead Park. I recommend members not familiar with forest schools to view the homepage of their website. The information and testimonies to be found there are truly inspiring. Forest schools are so much more than a field trip into the natural environment. Indeed, regular participation is required in order to reap the full benefits. Usually set in woodlands and other natural beauty spots, they provide a freer, more open context, not just for learning about nature, but also for exploration, discovery, and developing relationships. Forest schools are run by professionally trained practitioners whose holistic aim is to foster resilient, confident, independent, and creative learners. In a classroom setting, children have limited opportunities to learn to assess and manage the risks encountered in the real world. This is one of the many advantages which forest schools offer. Undoubtedly, forest schools have a therapeutic as well as educational role. They are known to help children with conditions such as ADHD and autism. A little girl who refused to speak in the classroom overcame this handicap gradually after attending a series of forest school sessions. Another little boy overcame a stammer, as I did then. And finally, many children for whom the usual rapid pace of the classroom is stressful and inhibiting finally have the time and space to learn to express themselves confidently in an outdoor setting where they are freer to take ownership of their own learning.
Thank you. Councillor Stuart Ritchie.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The Conservative objection to the proposed budget should really be submitted to the Booker Prize panel for the award of objection. In the imaginary world, that's where your colleagues inhabit. They crashed the economy 12 years ago. Councillors Lewis and Rennie claimed that it was Labour that caused the rate of increase in overall public spending to slow. What nonsense. In the 1980s, the Conservative government abolished the regulation of banks and finance houses in what we called the Big Bang. A bewildering array of dodgy deal came into play, creating a derivative market, a kind of multicoloured swap shop in which debts, mortgages, and assets were bought and sold in an endless game of pass the parcel. This all came to a head in September 2008 when the Lehman Brothers Bank crashed with a debt of $690 million. As far as I'm aware, no Labour members were on the Lehman board, nor on the boards of the other banks which fell out of my business. And the bulk of the deficit that built up in the final years of the last eight governments went on bailout banks. Public spending did not slow. It was cut to the bone by substance cut their Conservative governments. The poor, the unemployed, the children, the sick, the disabled were all paid back, with food banks, tracked suicides, and rampant inequality as a result. That politically driven austerity regime has shipped over £233 million from this council, and I reckon this council will have a third of their students going to be a year ahead. On council housing, does care. Perhaps the councillors have not seen on 2019 Ofsted reports on the provision for the service, which notes that services for children and poor have become a central council priority